I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Winter Haven. I'm Bradley, and you're watching BDTV for Thursday, April 6, 2023. Coming up on today's show is Yearbook and Baking with Tori. I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my mind. You got me stuck on the thought of you. You're making me feel brand new. You're more than a sunshine in my eyes. You got those pretty eyes in your head. You know it. You got me dancing in my bed, so let me show it. You are exactly what I want. Kinda cool and kinda not. Wanna give myself to you. Yeah, we're driving down the freeway at night. I only got one thing in the back of my mind. I'm feeling like this might be my time to shine with you, with you, with you. I got my head out the sunroof.
I'm Elle.
And I'm Caroline.
Let's get into the announcements.
Students, remember to check your email every day. You may receive testing information and other important news through your school email.
The April Scholarship Bulletin is out. If you have any questions, see Mrs. Bachman.
Seniors, you are to report all offers of scholarships to Mrs. Bachman, even if you don't accept them. This is a district requirement.
There will be a senior meeting April 13th in the auditorium, third block, where your cap and gowns will be distributed.
If you haven't ordered your cap and gown, orders have a late fee of $20. In order to walk the stage at graduation, you must have a cap and gown. So see Ms. Bachman for more information.
I bet there's a lot of seniors who will get a yearbook.
High school is a major milestone in life, but the farther you are into the future, the smaller it may seem. The memories become more distant and the relationships begin to fade. Buying a yearbook can help preserve some of the unique experiences of some of your most precious years. I'm Ellie with BTV, here to tell you more about yearbook. What goes into creating the yearbook?
Well, there are several elements that go into creating a great yearbook. First, we have to come up with our theme. So all the students brainstorm, we come up with our ideas, and then we vote on what theme we want to go towards. Then we create our cover. I usually take a group of kids during the summer to yearbook camp, and there we get inspired, we get training, we bring that back to school with us for the following school year, and then we run with our idea that we've chosen for our theme, and then we work towards getting our content to create our yearbook pages.
Why are you buying a yearbook?
Because I want to remember all my friends.
For all the baseball memories.
Because I don't have the money.
What has been your favorite part about being in yearbook?
My favorite part is definitely like the relationships that we do build because we're in here every day. I'm a freshman coming in and, you know, it's just very, you know, they were all warm and welcoming and I really enjoy it. So, and Dr. Jaime's the best, so.
With a yearbook, you'll be able to look back at a significant time period of your life. Yearbooks are great to go through with your friends, relatives, and possibly your future kids. Also, you'll never know who will become famous after graduation. Yearbooks are $80 and will go up to $90 in May. I'm Ellie with BTV. Make sure you buy your yearbook, Winter Haven.
I can't wait to see the Dutch exchange pictures in the yearbook.
Are you interested in hosting a Dutch student in October? Do you want to travel to the Netherlands for spring break next year? If so, use this QR code to fill out an application.
Our Aerospace Academy is doing fantastic. Last week, some members of the Blue Angels came to speak with them. Congratulations to Kamani Nelson and David Hagelstein for being the 9th and 10th students from the Aerospace program to receive the James C. Ray Scholarship.
The Color Guard is having an interest meeting April 26th from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. in the band room. Join the Pride of Winter Haven as we perform our field show at football games in the ReelQuest Bowl in Tampa. See Mr. Day Osis for more information.
Our Blue Devil track and field team will be attending the county championships this weekend on Saturday, April 8th at George Jenkins. So come out and support.
Do you think anyone on the track team likes baking?
Welcome back to the Kitchen with Baking with Tori, and today we're making a classic Southern treat, and that Southern treat is banana pudding. Now, banana pudding traces all the way back from 1878 when it first appeared in the New York Times. Now, to this day, there are many different recipes for banana pudding. I'm Tori BTV, let's get started.
Thank you.
great thing about banana pudding is that you can put it in any container that you need it for, whether it be for a study treat, a dessert for dinner, or for a friendly get-together. I'm Toy BTV, and let's see how our guest star likes the banana pudding.
10 out of 10.
I know Tori loves community service. Any students interested in getting community service hours, volunteers are needed for Hoops Haven spring and summer basketball camps and clinics. See Coach Woodside for more information. Coach Woodside is the Basketball Coach of the Year. Isaac Seliskar was named Polk County Basketball Player of the Year. KJ Parker and Dylan James made All-County First Team. Congrats to you all. Grad Bash will have a strict dress code. Please be sure to dress appropriately. Visit Grad Bash on the Universal website for more information. That's all we have for you today, Winter Haven. I'm Sydney with BDTV. Have a great day and stay tuned for pictures from prom and a tennis highlight.
Grad Bash is April 28th, and I know everybody's looking forward to it. But one thing's important. You need to remain in dress code, and I'm here to show you how. One of the most important dress code rules that we all have to follow is that there are no logos from Winter Haven High School allowed. That means no Winter Haven hoodies, no Winter Haven shirts, or shorts, or pants. Articles containing offensive material may not be worn to Grad Bash. No tank tops, undershirts, and sleeveless tops can be worn, and it is important that you do not show midriff or cleavage. No sagging is allowed, and undergarments should not be visible. Clothing with excessive holes or shredding, or clothes that show a lot of skin, are not allowed to be worn. Sharp accessories such as a collar or spiked chains are not allowed to be worn as they may cause danger to other people. Dress skirt and romper hemlines may not be shorter than mid-thigh. Large backpacks or purses are not able to be brought, and same with open water bottles. So make sure you follow the dress code and have a fun time at Grad Bash, Winter Haven.
I came to dance, 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 dance. I hit the floor cause that's my plans, 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 plans. I'm wearing all my favorite brands, 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 brands. Give me some space for both my hands, 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 hands. You, cause it goes.